Hello, I am Double H here with Riggs, and we are about to get into the 3-4 game here at the 2019 European Continental Cups for the WFTDA, and it is going to be a very exciting evening.
I am very excited. Medals on the line. Who wants one?
I do.
Yeah, I'd like a medal
okay,
as well.
Okay, great.
That's decided then. We'll just have medals for us. Never mind.
Unfortunately, the two teams who are contending for a medal at this point for this game are Kallio Rolling Rainbow and Perth Roller Derby.
They are indeed. And we saw Perth yesterday play some fantastic roller derby, and they totally deserve to be in this position fighting for a medal. I've not seen Perth before, and they've been an absolute joy to watch.
I agree. And we had Kallio taking on Dock City just a few games ago. That was a very physical game. It really pushed Kallio's defense a lot farther than they thought they could go at the time. But I'm really excited to see the last 10 minutes or so of that game. They really locked it in. So I'm expecting to see them fully locked in for the start of this game.
Absolutely. But it will be interesting to see how the Jammers have handled things, because those Dock City walls were just so intense at times. Like you said, the physicality in there was immense. But hopefully they're rested, they're refreshed, and they're ready to go.
Unlike us.
Unlike
All
us.
All right. Let's talk about these rosters.
So let me introduce you to Kallio Rolling Rainbow. We have 110 Satugusa, 113 L, 19 Kathy Schrodinger, number 2 Aika Helpo, number 21 Shenanigans, number 27 Jake Arpoff, number 3 Kuti, number 301 Mina, number 3 Kamasutra, number 410 Ovatuvima, number 49 Macho Bichu, number 57 Lionheart, number 60 KO, number 80 Mu, and number 9 Teabag. They are your Kallio Rolling Rainbow, and they will be playing in black today.
And the team playing in white will be Perth Roller Derby, 1111 Slay, 112 Fatality, 1953 Amodini, 21 BJ, 31 Molotov, 328 Peacock, 44 Wazer, 45 Fable, 56 Oop, 6060, sorry, it's going to be the whole game. 6060 Wood, 616 Shock, 77 Betty Yokosuka, 88 Thorson. And let's talk about our officials, because these crews have been on fire this weekend, Riggs. They have worked so hard, and the teams have gelled so well, the crews have gelled so well together. Let's talk first about the non-skating official team.
So let me tell you who they are. We have Pretty Miffed with us. We have Connie, Restless Bitchface, Speedy Convalesce, Festa, Kaiser Guze, Luna Kazam, and Strange Edge, Liz Fizzle, and Mimi First.
And our skating officials, Baff, Genuine, Major Buzzkill, Victoria Velociraptor, Caps Lock, Danny O'Rario, Total Miscall, and Shref.
And they have had almost everything thrown at them so far this weekend and have dealt with it absolutely beautifully. So hopefully we will have another fantastic game on our hands right here. There are skaters on the track and they are ready to go. So we have got Slay up first for Perth. Slay has been putting in some big jams for Perth, but going up against Karpov.
Yes, Yi Karpov. For Kallio, who's looking for some room on the outside, but Slay hung up at the back at the jammer line, tries to take an assist off the back, and the pack moving slowly towards the pivot line.
Yeah, Karpov having to work really hard, but is hoping that some room opens up on that inside line.
Not much, though. Closed pretty quickly.
That did indeed. But we see Slay pushing out in front and has picked up lead now for Perth.
And recycled, it looks like. So beautiful work here from Kallio, reabsorbing Slay as Yi Karpov recycled back to the pivot line. So although Slay has picked up lead jammer status, not a whole lot of progress.
Absolutely not. It's always good to see blockers making jammers. Ask them more than once. Just really making them earn that. So Karpov has stashed the star now.
Kallio tightening up their formation since their Dock City game here. Taking to the inside, Slay.
But we see Karpov coming through now. So not your lead jammer, but still eligible for points. But Kallio, with that control, are able to close the jam before points can be picked up.
And they really had dialed in the defense by the end of their Dock City game. They're taking that clearly into the first jam with no points on the board going into jam number two.
I think these guys are going to have to work very, very hard for every point they get.
Isn't that always the way?
It does, but this weekend it has felt like
just someday,
a little bit extra.
Someday it's going to feel easy, Riggs.
I mean, it's quite easy from over here. But we've got Fable right now out for Perth going up against number 31. That's Kama Sutra.
Kama Sutra is pushing forward to the pivot line and is able to make lead jammer status for Kallio. So this is two in a row for Kallio, and a star pass has been enacted from Fable.
Oh, huge jump there from Kama Sutra. Couldn't land it cleanly though, so has to recycle and we'll go all the way back to the jam start line.
And this is Peacock with the star now for Perth. Looking for some room on the outside, not able to find it. Meanwhile, Kama Sutra recycled as well. Both of these teams holding the line so well, Riggs.
So we have our first points of the game and they go to Kallio. 4 points put on the board.
The fans, although very polite, seem to like that.
They did. They did indeed. Now, here's a drama I have enjoyed watching this weekend. In fact, two of them. It's Shock versus Teabag on the line.
So Kallio on this back line, they do have the jammer line bench. And as we've mentioned before, the benches are across the track. So the line starts are going to be super important for them to get to quickly.
Talking of quickly, Shock making short work of the defense there, but
oh,
it's a track.
No, cutting the track penalty assessed, opening the door for Teabag, who's taken to the infield and recycled at turn one. Quick footwork pushing forward, though, all the way to turn three. A nice jumpy lateral movement, keeping Perth's walls moving. And a strike of offense to the inside from Kallio. Not fully able to spring their jammer. But Perth really refocusing here and pulling together that tripod smoothly to take Teabag all the way to the infield. And a forearm is being assessed. That's number 31, Molotov.
Absolutely, and we have Shock with the star. Cover in hand, doing battle with Kallio right here, right in front of us. And, oh, that looks like a very tough grind. As we said, Kallio locking down the defense here. Very smart play.
So, Teabag did have lead status, though, and removed the star. So this means that we will go another 43 seconds. Or there was no lead.
So that was a big hit coming in there from 6-0, 6-0. That's Wood for Perth, who has been doing that all weekend.
Well, all right. Okay, so pushing forward, both of these jammers, there's going to be a direction of gameplay assessed.
Oh!
That is going to Perth's 1953 Amonini.
Apologies for the sound effects there, but Schrodinger 1-9 with a beautiful hit on the inside.
Never apologize for sound effects. It's totally normal. What's not normal is the defense, otherworldly. So no initial yet, thus my confusion.
And we did see two jams just like that in the game that just happened between Tiger Bay and Dublin, where the jammers worked very hard for 2 minutes for no avail.
So 1-1-1-1 Soleil on the line for Perth, coming up against number 3, Kuti, who we didn't see a whole lot of jamming in the Dock City game, but quite a formidable jammer.
And Kallio do have the pack advantage, as Perth have one blocker in the box right now. Kuti looking to make that count. He's pushing hard at the front of the pack, but Perth managing to keep two blockers in front. Knockout, KO is in there, causing chaos as they have done the whole weekend.
Kuti finds some room, is able to become lead jammer. However, Slay passing Kuti, forcing the call off for Kallio. So no points on either of those jams. Does that make three scoreless jams in a row, Val? Our producer, Valkyria, confirming. Kallio 4, Perth nothing yet. Riggs?
Three jams in. four jams in, sorry, and it is looking like this is going to be a very close and low-scoring game so far. But anything can happen,
it's
and it
certainly
might well
kept
do.
Us on our toes, hasn't it?
This absolutely has, and Fatality is out there right now for Perth, going up against Karpov of Kallio, and it's Karpov up front, pushing hard at the front of the pack, finds room on the inside line and goes through to collect lead for Kallio.
So Fatality is still looking for some room, is not able to find much on the outside line at turn one. Beautiful blocking here from Kallio as Karpov makes their way into this wall of Perth. Spins around, there is a star stash happening.
Do indeed have a star stash, but Kallio doing a great job of just keeping things separated. But now, as I've said that, the star pass has happened, and that is number 21, BJ, taking the star there for Perth, so as we see Karpov coming
Perth back
in.
Trying to steal themselves for the impending strike from the jammer at the front with a tripod. Karpov looks around to the bench and says, should I call it? And there was some question there, but points grabbed before that call.
So 6 points picked up by Kallio in that jam. That pack got incredibly fast right towards the end, just trying to stay out of the jammer's line. So we have number 45, Fable, takes the line for Perth, going up against, I think that's Karpov. No, it's Kama Sutra.
Are you
my
just
apologies.
Going to whisper it to me?
We think it's Karpov.
No.
No, but it Kama is Kama Sutra, who is, in fact, your lead jammer right now for Kallio. Three in a row now for Kallio.
Well, I'll tell you what is not a whisper. This jamming coming into the apex, turn one. Kama Sutra is able to make it through for 4 points for Kallio.
So Fable has stashed the star now. Doing battle up front, spreads out those Kallio blockers, and one leaves a track for a penalty, making life just a little
yes,
bit
that
easier.
Yes, that was a multiplayer from Aika Helpo. So coming around the outside, Masuzra looking at the bench, backwards on one skate, decides to call it for four more points.
Aminini with some of the big hits in there, and Aminini has been quite a devastating blocker for Perth over this weekend.
Wow, additional scoring trips. Multi-passes, not too big yet in this game. So that was an 8-0 jam in Kallio's favor. The score, Kallio 18, Perth nothing. Just under 10 minutes has expired in this first period.
So your next matchup is Slay versus T-Bang. And Slay sees an open line on the inside and goes straight on through for lead for Perth.
So lead jammer status is assessed to Perth. T-Bag able to make it through as well, coming in to score at the back of the wall, making a little bump to open a hole, grabbing 4 points and calling it off.
And Kallio did really well to get out behind that, because we have seen Slay put up some of the biggest jams of the weekend. 24 points, I think, was what Slay managed to put up earlier, and it's only been beaten very recently, I think in the last game, with a 28-point jam. So keeping things down here.
So Kallio preferring to take that backline start. We are at an advantage, or 3-3. Yes, a blocker in the box, so 3-3, four blockers. Pusa for Kallio, Shock for Perth. Shock coming up against this tripod at the front for Kallio, looking for some space on the outside and not finding any.
So KO goes in to offer the offense for Kallio, as they've been doing for most of the weekend. And there it is, a very effective boost, who finds room to pick up lead. But it's, as I say that,
not
it's
a without a track cut.
You were
being assessed
for a moment.
All right, so this is an opportunity for Perth, looking for some daylight on the inside line at the apex of turn one and two. But some confusion from Perth on the offensive strategy here. And this is a star stash that's happening. So Shock does have the helmet cover in hand. Two to beat at turn three. Whistles being assessed. It looks like an out of play being called against the pivot for Kallio. And because the star was removed, there is no lead assessed. But making it through is Shock.
So we are going to go for the full 2 minutes here as we see Schott coming back in to do battle with Kallio at the entrance of turn three. It's a two-wall from Kallio, and it is doing a fabulous job of containing Schott right now as we see Husa right at the back tangling with that Perth tripod, which is determined to go nowhere. So four more points for Perth. And additional work here from Husa at the back from Kallio. And so Perth really clinging together on that inside line at turn two. Meanwhile, Schott coming in for additional points as well. Husa does find an opening and gets on through, looking to force the call off here. Oh, can't call the force the call off. Nobody is lead, I do apologize.
Correct. We have five more seconds to enjoy here, Riggs. Okay, great.
I'm going to force the call off. Oh, wait, you can't. So we have Perth sitting on at 12 right now. Kallio taking themselves to 20. It's an 8-point game right now.
Scary Spooky Sparks on Derby Twitter saying, holy defense about this game, and I concur.
We have seen some blocking like you wouldn't believe this weekend, and we're going to get another fantastic demonstration of that right here.
And what I like about Kallio is they're being pretty definitive about grabbing that back line, pushing back to the jammer, which is Perth's fatality. Yukarpov is jibbing for Kallio, looking for some space on the outside line off the start.
Oh, and that was Lionheart forcing out the Perth jammer. Big recycle, at least 10 foot back from the jam line, and has to reset to go again.
As if to illustrate the holy defense. Both teams able to maintain their formations to the extent that not much is moving here.
We are only just approaching the pivot line right now as 30 seconds has elapsed in this jam. These jammers are in for a grind this afternoon.
And a multiplayer assessed. That's another penalty for Amonini, 1953. And a lead jammer assessed to Karpov.
But we have a star pass from Perth, so BJ is now the jammer of record. It's about half a lap behind Karpov.
Coming through the inside line, 1-2 beat. And that was a call-off, but not before that final point was grabbed, strangely enough. So Kallio at 23, Perth at 12. What are your thoughts on the holy defense, Riggs?
Holy indeed. In fact, actually, if there were holes in it, the jammers would be very happy now.
Agreed. The opposite of holy defense would be
unholy?
Unholy. Unholy, absolutely.
Get yourself an unholy war like we're seeing here this afternoon. But Kamasutra is pushing up front, trying to push the first blockers out of play as we see Slay right at the back being held beautifully by Kallio, and lead is established by Kamasutra.
So now getting some assistance is Slay, who finds a bit of offense, tries to take a whip around the outside, is successful. Scoring in here for Kamasutra. And it will be 3 points.
Yep, we do have 3 points.
Three, yes.
So Kamasutra, number 31, is sitting on 100% lead right now with 15 points picked up. So very effective for Kallio right now.
Kallio 26, Perth 12. We've got 15 minutes left in the first period, and Kallio right on that back line. They're getting ready for that 5 seconds and pull back into the jammer from Perth, which is Fable. Teabag jamming for Kallio has 3 to beat at the front, and Perth's tripod not able to withstand a whole lot of Teabag.
Teabag is deep in that tripod right now, driving through, and in comes Lionheart to offer the offense here. Not terribly effective, but it does move the pack on, has split up, and penalties have been issued. So that all added up to seeing Teabag come away with lead.
Fable with the star in hand at turn one, looking for a star stash or star pass opportunity to get through this pack. Meanwhile, Teabag coming back to the inside. In fact, all the way to the inside is recycled. And very wisely kind of judges position from the opposing jammer in that part of the pack. So slow. Teabag's very slow to engage here at the back.
So Kallio were doing a fantastic job of absorbing the offense there, and the only way out for Perth was to get that star pass off to BJ. So right now, Kallio sitting on 7 leads, but Perth only picking up 2 so far in this opening. We're over halfway through the first half. I don't know how that's happened, but when you're watching quality derby like this, 15 minutes goes by just like that.
When you're hanging out at a table, just talking about roller derby, time tends to pass quickly.
It does indeed. Shock is out there right now going up against Gutu for Kallio. And it is a fast and furious pack as we head up to the pivot line.
And Kuti hung at the back with a tripod from Perth. And then Shock taken to the inside, but recycled. And actually just 1 to beat now. 2 nice little pop of offense from the front. And it looks like there's some pack integrity issues as folks are able to reassemble. So now the entire pack is ground at turn 1. Both jammers stuck behind their respective walls.
And this is why we're seeing the penalties become so relevant in these games, because once you drop to 3 blockers, you really are forced into that defensive formation, aren't able to offer your jammers any offense, and that has really made the difference.
So that is a lead call for Shock. Perth looking to score additional points here. They only have 12 to Kallio's 30. So a beautiful recycle here from Kallio, taking Shock all the way back, and Shock trying to figure out how much time before Kuti hits the pack and decides to call it.
So 3 points were picked up there. They're going to Perth, and they are now 15 points behind Kallio. So 616, who is Shock, who was just out jamming, does have 100% lead right now, doing a sterling job out there.
So Perth, I think, pretty wisely deciding here that they want to try to get in on this backline action and see what they can disrupt here.
And we've seen this all weekend. The moment the whistle goes, those jammers are being pushed back on the jam line and having to work that extra 4 or 5 foot before they even get over the jam line.
Including Slay, who's looking for some room on the outside. Kallio doing a good job of keeping Slay behind them. Meanwhile, beautiful drawback here of Karpov at the back from Perth. And there's that offense we keep talking about from Lionheart, who's done a great job in both of these games that I've seen today with that offense. Slay is lead jammer for Perth. So another opportunity for Perth. Beautiful spin to the outside to grab 4 points.
Now, if the Perth blockers can keep hold of Karpov, then this presents an excellent opportunity for Slay, who we know is a fan of putting up the multiple point passes. But Kallio wise.
I mean, really, aren't we all?
I mean, I'm a fan.
I'm a fan.
But right now, I tell you who's not a fan, Kallio, they say no. And in reply, Slay says, nope, that's mine.
All right, so here's an opportunity for Perth's multi-pass. That's 8 points deep in this jam, 7 points to make up.
And that was a lovely move there from Slay, just going straight into the wall and a lovely step to the left on the inside to see them through for a 3rd scoring pass.
So Perth able to reform pretty well around Karpov. Slay is taken to the infield and recycled back towards the jammer line. And Karpov is through. Slay is going to try to grab a couple more points and calls it successful on that. A 12-0 jam, 14-0 jam in Perth's favor. Now a 1-point game, Riggs.
This is what I came for.
Oh, it is?
The close stuff, absolutely.
I heard it was the snacks.
They have good too.
So we're going to have an official review from Kallio. We'll see exactly if they're going to take it as a timeout or if they actually have an item to review.
So that last jam by Slay was the highest scoring jam for Perth at 14 points. Kallio's largest jam so far is 8 points. I'm just having a quick squidge at the penalties. Nothing major going in there. We do see Aminini picking up some penalties, but Aminini is a very active blocker, often involved in the big moments that we see from Perth. So quite understandable a little bit with the work rate that goes on with that. But 3 penalties for Kamasutra.
And it did look like a Molotov. Using the official review as a timeout, which is totally allowed. And probably a good way. Kallio did use, I believe, two of their team timeouts in the last game. It's always good to be able to have.
So Kallio's official review is about a back block call for the white jammer.
Oh, well, that's okay too. You can use your official review to actually review something.
It's always worth a try. So just having a look at some of the stats here that our wonderful producer Val is providing us. And Slay right now has collected 18 points so far and is sitting on a 60% lead ratio. Is it a ratio or is it just a percentage? I mean, that's maths. That's out of my comfort zone. I'm going to go with percentage.
I'm going to say percentage.
I'm sure somebody will let me know.
A ratio means you said something ridiculous on Twitter, I'm told.
Oh, right. Okay.
After reviewing the situation, the no call stands. The initial contact was made to the side. Thank you.
You know, that was a good try from Kallio, though. I think it's totally legit and welcome to try to slow the momentum that Perth showed in this last jam. Kallio, though, not so keen to give up the back line on this start. I think they feel much more comfortable starting in the back. They do not like letting Perth, but Perth just going for it at the 5 seconds.
Yeah, Peacock in there just moving bodies out of the way, but that hasn't stopped Kamasutra from picking up lead for Kallio.
So Fatality still looking for some daylight in the pack. Is Kamasutra able to make it through? And as lead, scoring points now and getting sent out of bounds very strangely in recycled back. I wasn't sure if there was a recognition of something there.
But we do have boot in the box for Perth and will be frozen in there for the next jam. So Kallio will have a pack advantage.
So 4 points, a 4-0 jam in Callio's favor. Kallio 34, Perth 29, 9 minutes and 2 seconds left in the first period.
I think one of the things I like about both of these teams is they are smart. They're not just physical, they're smart as well. They're really able to adapt to the tactics of their opposition, and that's something I've been watching all weekend and just admiring, quite frankly. So it is Fable right now versus Teabag, and it is a scrum off the line, but Fable, strong and stable, gets on through for lead for Perth. I say that, back block signs are being given. I know it, Fable now knows it.
Not too happy about it, but Teabag able to come in to scoring position at turn one, baiting to the outside with a sweep on the in, recycled, and waiting for some patient offense to clear an opening on the outside. So 4 more points here for Kallio.
And so far, Perth have picked up 2 jammer penalties, and Kallio doing a great job. They're going to freeze.
We do have an injury on the track. Ooh. So we have an injury at turn one that we may want to avoid showing. Excellent.
There we go. Look at our shiny floor. Welcome to Europe. Admire our many lines. Yes?
I have heard that Europe is the home of roller derby and lines, and that is why I came. Came for the roller derby. I came for the lines.
I'm used to the lines. The lines are my life.
So know? In America, you come for the lack of lines.
Right. Yes. I see. And your lovely polished concrete floors that I often admire.
I've heard of them. I don't get one, but I've heard of them.
That's my dream. I don't even particularly play, but I have to say, some of those lovely polished concrete floors that I've seen make me want to put a pair of skates on.
Oh, I thought you were going to say make you want to come to America.
Well, I do.
It would take a lot,
to
probably, to want to make you come to America. But
well, I mean, you do have a few things that are slightly off-putting at the moment. But I think we're matching you here in the UK,
yes.
But we're not here in the UK. We're in the lovely Finland, which has a very sensible
in
prime minister.
In our heart, we are always in the UK.
But yeah.
Except for Valkyria, who is making a face that tells us otherwise.
I don't think we should bring Boris up at all. That's all I'm saying. You know, just because they've got matching hair, That's all we need to know. Anyway, let's get back to business, please. It's Jikobo out there with a power jam start as Fable was frozen in the box at the end of that last jam. And look again at Perth pushing back, sucking up any space Ikapov had, but they did not protect the outside line, and the speed of Ikapov puts them in lead.
So this is still a power jam situation here for Kallio, who pushes the whole pack forward as Fable gets back on the track with the helmet cover in hand. So Ikapov is the lead and is on the scoring pass as Fable pushing forward with the star in hand, just trying to make it through on an initial.
The KO in there trying to play defense and offense at the same time just to help Karpov out, but the big recycle is initiated.
And Fable still trying to make some work. Now the pack has condensed again.
Oh, Peacock in there with some bruising shots to Ikapov.
So the pack almost frozen at turn three. In the front of the pack is Perth. A bit of offense here from Kallio, able to keep Fable behind with the star in hand.
I tell you what I've really enjoyed is the way that KO hangs out at the front of the pack and is always the last line of defense. Just holds onto the jammer a little bit until reinforcements arrive, but Fable had to work so hard right then.
Unholy defense indeed. Karpov looks behind and sees Fable in scoring position and calls it, but 4 points for Kallio on that jam.
And again, Kallio playing the smart game, grab the points, shut out Perth, and keep creeping away from them.
So just about 6 minutes and 12 seconds left in this first period. Kallio 42, Perth 29. So Perth again trying to grab some space on that back line, seeing if they can absorb Kallio's jammer. But Kallio not too keen to give up that line.
I think everybody's on that back line right now, which gives Slay and Busa very little room to work with. In fact, they're having to step through the pack right now, but the pack gives, and Busa hits the floor, but is up again and ready to keep pushing. BJ does pick up a penalty there.
Two to beat at the front for Pusa, and lead jammer status is awarded for Kallio's jammer. So Slay still trying to make some room at the front of the pack to get through at the pivot line, though, and a beautiful tripod here to hold Pusa.
I mean, I don't want to call it unholy, but there comes the hole, and that was due to Wazer getting a penalty.
Additional multiplayer calls have been problematic for both of these teams so far in this game. It is the predominant penalty, specifically on Perth's side. So a 4-0 jam in favor of Kallio, 46 over Perth 29.
So we have just 5 minutes left of this half, and it looks like we are having an official review. Perth with arms in the air, desperately looking for attention.
The skaters on the track are letting the officials know there's an official review.
There's been some lovely communication today between players and officials. I think my favorite moment was a jammer earlier. I didn't hear a black block, and the opposition blocker gave him a little tap and just went, just so you know, got a back block. It was the kindest and cutest thing I have seen in roller derby in quite a while.
So Kallio at 46, Perth at 29, 4 minutes and 47 seconds. In the jams we've had so far, which have totaled 17. Oh, we do have an official review explanation.
We shall be quiet now.
Perth is using their official review as a timeout.
Okay.
You.
That answers that question.
Out of 17 jams total, Kallio has scored in 12 of them, Perth in 4. So 29 points in 4 jams, and Kallio a much more evenly metered out number of points per jam.
And that is still because Perth put up their high scoring jam of 14 points earlier, thanks to Slay.
So this is going to come to a conclusion, this official review, as a timeout. And we're going to get back into gameplay. We do have blockers for both teams in the box, with the pack advantage going to Kallio.
And Kamasutra making short work of that one to beat, and does so.
Shock jamming for Perth.
And being held brilliantly by Perth behind the line. Only just passing the jam line right now. having to try and slalom through those blockers. The offense there was helpful. Thorson really helping to get Shock out of the pack there.
So coming back into scoring position is Kamasutura, who is on the far straightaway, grabbing points, recycled. And those are 3 points that were earned on that last pass. So a 7-0 jam in favor of Kallio. And you know, for a lot of the feedback that I gave them during the Dock City game about their formations and the positioning of their contact on the jammer, it is really working for them against Perth.
Indeed. So, tell you else what works. The S1 Lifer helmet, the best fit plus superior protection equals made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer.
Teabag and Slay. Kallio looking to add one more to their 5 leads in a row. Pushing through the middle is Teabag. A nice reform here, though, at the pivot line from Perth.
And we're seeing some lovely one-hand magic from Slay right here on both sides of the track. Oh, but talking of magic, Teabag with some magic moves to collect lead for Kallio.
So Slay still working on this outside line, is taken all the way out at turn one and recycled back. Meanwhile, 4 points grabbed by Teabag.
Stolen out of the air there. Oh, it looks like we've got an attempted star pass here.
Oh no, there was a, it looks like the helmet cover was grabbed off the floor, so it must be handed back to the jammer, which it was, so that it may be legally passed.
Gotta keep these star passes legal.
Yeah, that was a very good recognition here from BJ the Pivot.
Again, that Derby intelligence on display from these teams here.
But Slay looked a little bit bummed to have to pick it back up, even though Slay has broken the pack.
So Teabag has 8 points already, is coming in on a third scoring pass and says, nope, I'm just going to stop Slay from getting any points. That'll do me nicely. There are just 2 minutes and 15 seconds left of this first half, of this bronze medal game.
And an 8-0 jam just then from Kallio. So firmly 61 over Perth's 29. 2 minutes and 3 seconds left in the first period, as you've mentioned.
Okay, so we are doubling the score here. And Perth have been held scoreless for 6 jams now.
And Perth is trying something new. They're trying that pivot line start in the front with Fatality jamming. Yikapov jamming for Kallio, looking for some room on the inside. Perth had their formation fully set, which is why I think they really liked grabbing that pivot line start. And this is where they feel most comfortable, full formation in full force.
There's a lovely longing look on Fatality's face. Just please, somebody, bring me the offense. Vima, though, with the drawback, makes Fatality start it all over again.
Meanwhile, Lionheart eagerly helping Yikarpov as possible, but getting a penalty as a result. Lead jammer status assessed to Yikarpov, and meanwhile, a star pass from Perth.
That is number 56. Boop.
I thought you might go for saying it straight, so I had to get in there with the sound effects. The sound effects are okay.
I've decided if you can't beat them, join them.
That is the sound effect when the star pass was made.
Boop. Have you tried Atom Savant wheels? See what you've been missing at atomskates.com.
Kallio 65, Perth 29. 30 seconds left, so plenty of time for another jam. And Perth really eager to get the formation set in the front ahead of time. And Kallio very smartly tries to break that apart. Kuti jamming for Kallio, Fable for Perth. Kuti has this really very solid tripod at the front of turn one. And in the back, Kallio able to hold Fable.
There was an excellent run back there from Shenanigans, who is now part of that wonderful tripod, really containing Fable. But out in front, with a massive smile on her face, goes Kuti. Your lead jammer for Kallio. But we see another star pass. That is the 6th star pass of the game for Perth. And that is BJ taking the star this time.
The pack on the far straightaway with a call off. And we are going to head into halftime with this. Kallio 65, Perth 29. Are you going to be okay, Riggs?
I don't know if I am, but to be honest with you, that was 8 jams in a row that Kallio controlled the game into the half. But we know Perth have got so much more in their tank, in their tactics. It's not over.
I think the difference for Kallio has been commanding those jam starts, commanding that line, picking their positioning and taking it, and then also getting in Perth's way whenever possible so that they do not feel fully set up. So there are quite a few non-scoring jams, 8 in a row, that Perth has had.
That is some holy defense.
Unholy defense.
Just a block of goals today. Yes. We have seen so much excellent work from the blockers. I have been so impressed. Normally I come for the apex jumps, but today that block of work and that teamwork, the communication has been such a beautiful thing to watch.
And I came for the lines, but today the jammers have not been able to access them.
Those lines are being shut down indeed.
Well, we are going to take a quick break and we will be right back with the second half of Kallio versus Perth.
Welcome back, friends, to the bronze medal game here in Helsinki, Finland for the 2019.
You have to think about that for a second.
I'm definitely in Helsinki because it's freezing cold here.
I made you take us in and then I made you LOL.
I mean, it's okay. It's
where
okay.
Are we again?
We're in Pasila in Helsinki in Finland. And we are here for the 2019 WFTDA Continental Cup Europe. And we are playing for bronze. Well, not we. Kallio.
We are watching.
We are watching.
You are watching. They are playing.
You are watching some excellent derby right here between Kallio Rolling Rainbow and Perth Roller Derby. And oh, we had a first half, didn't we?
Let's talk about it.
So in the first half, we saw Kallio take lead 15 times, which is quite impressive, with just one jammer penalty. They only used one star pass, and obviously you guys can see the score of 65 right up there. And as we ended that half, it was an 8 in a row lead streak holding Perth scoreless, which is why their score is sitting down there on 29. They've only had lead 4 times, and they've picked up 2 jammer penalties. So a star pass is working for them, though.
Yes.
They are. If we look at the stats from before, we've only seen like 2 multiple passes from Kallio.
Yep.
But it's a consistent 4-4-4-4-4 while holding Perth back.
And it's worked for them. As you can see, the score is 65 to Perth 29. One of the things that we were talking about earlier is the fact that Kallio's formations had not been as successful against Dock City. But those two teams know each other so well that they have a more nuanced understanding of the formations. And so Dock City's jammers were just hitting those seams, trying to get those linkages, forcing those multiplayer calls. And Perth is having a little bit of trouble adapting to that style of holding the brace.
And they absolutely are, but we are off again and we will find out if Perth have got an answer for Kallio's tactics. Slay is looking for room on the outside, finds it after putting KO on their behind.
So Kamasutra also looking for some space, able to find it about half a track behind Slay. Slay now coming in for a scoring pass on the outside line, is able to make a few points happen. Before that call off, it is all 4 points.
That is the first time Kamasutra has not been lead
jammer. Excellent.
Nice work there, which will have improved Slay's percentage, because Slay going into that jam was sitting on 43% lead jam. Also have 616, which is Shock, who's racked up 11 points so far, but has a 75% lead jammer percentage.
So Perth taking that back wall and Shock getting recycled and Karpov getting recycled. So both of these packs, both of these pieces of the pack doing a beautiful job. At the front is Perth with the tripod and an additional protector dropping back to execute some offense here for Shock, trying to make a clear.
And it is a grind. It turns 1 and 2 right now.
So as we were talking about, though, there is a penalty being assessed to the pivot. That's Peacock for Perth. That has been the problem with some of the offense from Perth today, is that it has not been quite precision, and so there are a little bit of difficult penalties that are happening.
And we,
Go ahead.
We see Kallio picking up lead with Ekupov coming around now on a scoring pass. But in the meantime, there's an explosion of speed and a huge hit coming in there. And almost looking slightly embarrassed about it was the pivot of Kallio. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hit you quite so hard.
So coming into the back of that pack, still shock, looking for some room to work. Ekupov recycled back fairly far by shock.
Ekupov was having none of that.
Yeah, I was going to say that is not something that was really enjoyable. A 4-0 jam in Kallio's favor now at 70 points per 33. So the benches have switched, of course, at the half, and now the shorter distance to the jammer line is owned by Perth, and we'll see if they're able to be any more aggressive in grabbing that back line off the start. They do have a blocker in the box.
It is tight, right on the line. Nobody is going anywhere. Slay and Pusa separate. One goes inside, one goes outside. Pusa with far more success. Driving through the pack, stays in bounds. Oh, not quite. And everybody's getting hit out. Pusa not entirely sure where to come back on at the end of all that. Does so safely.
And Slay finds some room, able to make it through, not lead. So still an opportunity, which is grabbed by Kallio after a call-off. 100% lead jammer status for Pusa. Not too shabby.
Not too shabby at all. And Kallio are doing fantastically well at holding Perth scoreless. In the last 10 jams, that includes the ones in the first half, they've only allowed Perth to pick up 4 points.
So a pack advantage here for Perth off this start. They are going to try to get in the defensive formation at this start for Kallio. So we've got Teabag and Fatality. Fatality trying to look for some room on the outside, pushing forward, just grabbing, reaching a toe stop around to see if there's any daylight on the outside line. And Kallio says, no, there is not.
Also in the no club is Peacock, who keeps denying Teabag on that inside line. Teabag now pushing to the outside, or maybe it's going, can I get through the middle? But no, the recycle is there, and that is number 77, Betty Yokosuka.
So 30 seconds and no lead so far, and a penalty is assessed to Teabag. That is going to be a cutting the track penalty. Oh, or some both jammers grabbing penalties at the same time.
Everybody have a sit down. Everybody go backwards. Let's start this all over again. We've still got 1:11 on the clock. Plenty of time now for everybody to get involved and get some points.
So the pack now back at the jam start, between the jam start and the pivot lines. The tripod of Kallio in the back holding Fatality. And up front, we've got Teabag pushing forward the pack at a slow grind. The helmet cover comes off of Fatality.
Oh, and KO goes in hard on that Perth tripod, comes back to make sure the pack stays in one.
But the pivot Fable breaks formation to drop back and grab that star. Successful star pass for Perth.
Absolutely, as we see Peacock taking Teabag off on the outside, avoids the hit of KO, and is a huge recycle here.
So coming in for point scoring is Fable. A full complement of blockers, though, to beat here from Kallio at the front. Looking behind for some offense. Gets a tiny bit from Fatality.
And after all of that work, 2 points picked up by Perth in that jam. Taking them to 35, exactly halfway behind Kallio.
So it is super risky to leave a formation defensively against Kallio, but Perth was able to do it, and I think you have to have great communication as a pack to have one of those rear blockers just leave formation and grab the star, and they communicated that so well. Meanwhile, Kamasutra and Shock jamming.
Kamasutra started on that jam line like a sprinter and just launched through the pack. Pivots all kind of like that, just like that. You're riding the momentum from the hit from Amanini to go on through for 4 points.
So additional entry to the pack is shut down here by Shock at the back with the star in hand. Now joining the defense, joining the wall here.
And we see, Kama Sutra just going straight through the middle of the pack, over people if necessary.
So the pack now between turns one and two.
Oh, great line work from Shock there.
Shock is able to make it through with the star stash. Kama Sutra looking at the bench saying, do I call it? Yes. And this was a multi-pass. So that was an 11-0 jam in their favor. Kallio now 81-35 for Perth.
So if you want to do some fancy toe-stop work on the outside, you're going to need yourself some good toe-stops. And I tell you what, you should try Gumball toe-stops because they are proud to bring you this WFTDA tournament stream. Gumball, the first and the best.
So that was the highest scoring jam for Kallio, now at 81 points. We've got Yikarpov and Slay. Slay, lead jammer status right off the line.
That was fantastic work from Slay. And already back round, looking to score. Finds beautiful amount of room on the inside. Goes up the inside, removes 113 out of the way. That was out.
And a forearm being assessed on that pass, though.
I thought it was too good. Every time I think something's brilliant, a penalty gets called.
I mean, it can be brilliant. It still is brilliant.
Still brilliant, but penalized nonetheless. So we see Ikapov coming back into the pack. Perth set up and ready. KO. No, sorry, that's number 80, who is in there.
So the pack slows at the far straightaway. It is a power jam. Perth jammer is standing. Slay getting ready to re-enter gameplay. And able to maintain toe stop room on the inside, making it through. Were we not just talking about the importance of toe stops?
We absolutely were, and Slay used them on both sides of the track there. Actually re-entered level with the blockers.
Oh, gorgeous screen from Perth as Slay comes around to score points.
Sometimes the beautiful work that these skaters put in just makes me stop talking. But as we say that, Ikapov picks up 4 points for Kallio.
Nice work here defensively from Perth. They're going to use this to run the points. So they've got 12 already in this jam. They're counting on their defense to try to slow Karpov down, but it's not as effective as they would like it to be.
And Slay has been slowed down and is being held right at the pivot line right now as we see Ikapov looking for that apex jump. Can't quite make it though. Slay says, oh, that inside line looks nice. I'll have a go. Kallio said, no, no, not even with your magic one-hand trick.
That's 3 additional points on that last pass for Perth. 2 for Kallio, so an even jam. 15-15, Kallio 96, Perth 50. Then now we're in the running long game here, Riggs.
These guys are going to leave it all on track. This is their last game of the day, and there is a medal on the line. It is time to turn up the tempo as we see Kuti out front for Kallio. Fatality at the back, pushing against that Kallio tripod.
Coming in for some offense was KO. And pushing forward is Fatality, who's drawn back almost all the way to the jammer line. Must reset.
And it isn't just the jammers who need to have that great toe stop work, as well as we saw Vakavima strong on the line, able to stay inbound and then force the drawback. But round the outside, Fatality's looking for room.
And Kuti is looking for some offensive assistance as well and not able to get it. Perth has locked Kuti down at turn one, looking for some help, but Kallio cannot help. Kallio is definitely hung up. So both parts of the pack pushing forward as the crowd begins to cry. Moving forward to the far straightaway, we still do not have a lead assessed. We are just over 1 minute into this jam.
There was a lovely little conversation there going on between Fable.
And then the helmet cover was removed.
Absolutely.
So yep. Now Fatality with that star, trying to do some fake work, not quite working out.
Oh, that was a big hit from KO there. Just cleaning out number 77, Betty Yokotuka.
So a minute 30 in and we have lead. That is Kuti from Kallio. But we have a star pass that has been executed.
So after a little chat with Faye, Fatality, Fable says, yep, I'll take the star for you. I'm ready to do that now. But in fact, is got eyes on the defense right now, trying to make sure they play the smart derby. And we've just come to a standstill here on the jam line.
Kuti looking for some offense is not finding it. And I think you got to see how many points we've got. That was 2 points that Kuti was able to grab on that pass in this entire jam. And so I think for close to 2 minutes, Kuti had to ask, is this worth it? How far should I push myself? With the score of Kallio 98 to Perth 50, 17 minutes and 40 seconds in. And that question was answered with 2 points.
Certainly was. So Perth have put out Shock next to jam up against Teabag. And that is a really blended pack off the line.
Agreed.
Once more.
I'm not sure I would have enjoyed that. I don't think the Teabag does either, but Shock able to find some room on the outside to become lead jammer. So Perth, trying to get back into this game firmly, is able to recycle Teabag as well as Shock comes in for a point scoring pass.
So we do have the star stash now for Teabag. And Shock is driving hard up at the front of the pack. But Kallio again, that defensive lockdown, working beautifully. And we see Shock with a longing look over the shoulder. But that helps just distract the Kallio blockers enough for the line to open up and for Shock to go on through.
So 4 points here for Shock and Perth. Here's that formation that we've been talking about, that outside line being shut down.
But
that
now
was Kati Schrodinger,
surrounded by the Perth blockers there. But that star pass right at the end to Lionheart there for Kallio. And Perth picking up 7 points in that jam.
So a multi-pass, 7-0 jam in Perth's favor. 57 points is where they sit now to Kallio's 98. 16 minutes and 13 seconds left in the game.
So you guys heard about Derby Without Borders? Check them out at derbywithoutborders.org to see how you can help support the growth of roller derby around the world. Please remember to bring your donations to 2019 champs.
Kama Sutra for Kallio and Slay for Perth. Both jammers trying to play defense against one another for a moment as Slay launches forward to the outside, maintains position on the track boundary and pushes forward to the pivot line. And there is a forearm assessed to a blocker from Perth.
That was Wood who picked up the penalty there. As we see Kama Sutra get on through, but closely followed by Slay, who puts the burners on to try and close the distance between Kama Sutra. But Kama Sutra is not exactly a slow jammer.
No, and Perth running for the front, trying to get away from being a point. Shutting down the outside line effectively enough that only 2 points were grabbed by Kallio, but one stolen by Perth.
And Kallio do in fact take themselves to that century mark, 100 points on the board now against Perth 58. And we are into the last half of the last half of this bronze medal game.
Mr. Whistler on Twitter says, this is a game of thirds. Perth's points were all scored in the middle 10 minutes. During the 29-12 run, Kallio went 18-0 in the first third. Perth needs more middle third. We would agree with that as Fatality jams. And this is Shenanigans for Kallio. So Shenanigans able to find lead jammer status for Kallio. Lining up the point scoring process here as Fatality passes the star.
And that is going to be Peacock. I'd recognize those leggings anyway. They're very helpful Peacock printed leggings, just to let you know, just in case you didn't get the name on the back.
Very on brand.
Very on brand, in fact. So let me just tell you about some of the fantastic jammers we've got here today. Kama Sutra, number 31 for Kallio, has picked up 40 points so far in this game. Closely followed, though, by Slay, 1111, who has picked up 38 points so far, which you wouldn't necessarily expect looking at the score differential, but it has all fallen on Slay's shoulders this afternoon.
So Perth starting, closing over the formation of Kallio with Pusa jamming for Kallio, Shock for Perth. And now Shock makes an attempt to get through the middle of the pack, a nice pop of offense here from Perth. So that was BJ.
So Pusa currently sitting on 100% lead jammer status. But right now, it does look like Perth have got a little bit of the hang of Pusa right now. And there goes Pusa's 100% lead jammer status as we see Shock get on through to pick up lead.
So the pack is at turns one and two. The helmet cover has been removed by Pusa. It is in hand. And trying to make a push through the middle of the pack is Pusa. Meanwhile, Shock trying to score points at turn two. Beautifully moving those feet, trying to push that tripod forward.
And KO is patiently in there, was looking to play some offense. And there we go, KO right back at the front, but now joined by BJ. It's a pivot battle right out of the front. They're ready. And in fact, BJ says, I know what you're up to, KO.
Yes.
I'm watching you.
Those are two pivots who know exactly what they're supposed to be doing.
They do indeed. And, oh, looking on the line. Oh my God, that was amazing footwork right there. Shock doing the business. And Shock has been doing the business. 18 points plus whatever Shock picks up in this jam so far. But Pusa out of the pack now.
The pack at the far straightaway. That's going to be a call off. Additional points scored on that? No. So that is a 4-0 jam in Perth's favor. Perth 62, Kallio 103, 12 minutes and 2 seconds left in the game. I am Double H here with Riggs, and you are watching the 2019 European Continental Cup from Helsinki, Finland.
Well, I'm glad somebody knows where we are. So if you've missed any of the action...
I read it on a piece of paper. That's the only reason I know it.
If you've missed any of the action from the 2019 postseason, don't worry, we've got you covered. Go to twitch.tv/WFTDA and subscribe.
Speaking of cover, this line coverage from both teams on fire with Slay and Kama Sutra. Out first is Kama Sutra, about an eighth of a track behind, though, is Slay. So Perth trying to get up to the front, and that's going to be a call-off from Kama Sutra.
Oh, the highest scoring jammers going head-to-head in that jam, and funnily enough, coming out with no points. Nil points.
Which is great for Kallio, because they're able to just hold place. Meanwhile, the entire stadium has awoken, Riggs. They have come to life as if to hear us complain about it earlier.
I don't know what Gretchen said to them, but it worked.
Whatever Gretchen and River, our house announcers, have been saying in the last 5 minutes, it has worked.
They have woken up, and Fatality is trying to wake up that Kallio defense and find some holes, but it is unholy right now, despite the efforts of BJ, who is in there trying to interfere with that tripod.
It's really difficult to gauge whether you need to be in an offensive or defensive position at any given moment as the pivot. And both of these teams have had really strong pivot presence throughout this game. So opting to become defense right now is BJ against Karpov. Fatality with 4-to-beat and dropping back to perform offense of their own is KO, and it works. Karpov is through for lead.
It does indeed, because we do in fact have a purse blocker in the box, which left with only 3 on track. And oh, sailing on by is Karpov. 1 foot round the outside, round the outside.
So a star pass over on Perth's side.
That was a huge
to BJ.
Huge hit to BJ. They just took a moment before picking themselves back up. And getting dropped by Wood was Karpov, but Karpov also quickly back up. And this is some one-on-one blocking. Oh, it's like that bit when you're trying to dance with somebody in the street. Like, are you going to go left? Am I going to go right? But actually,
that was much more graceful than what I do on the street bumping into somebody. I'm just going to say that.
That's good to know. I'm never going Christmas shopping with you.
Back to the action. Karpov able to make quick work of that pass. 4 more points. We are 12 deep here for Kallio. Nothing for Perth. We do still have the pivot who has accepted the star. That is BJ looking for some offensive help at turn 3.
Molotov, though, all over those toe stops to make sure that Karpov has to go back.
And BJ's able to make it through for an initial. Karpov taking a look at the bench and saying, okay, I guess I should call it now. What exciting defense.
So the Perth are picking up a number of blocker penalties in this second half. So Perth sitting on a total of 23 penalties right now. Kallio have 15. 4 of those have been picked up in the second period. 9 have been picked up by Perth in the second period. So penalties, not a huge impact on this game, but they are starting to add up now.
Starting the next jam, we've got
It's Slay for Perth, who is your lead jammer with no time at all, but less than 5 seconds to get the jammer.
Beautiful work there. And it is Kuti who has removed the star and passed it.
And that
is Lionheart, who is going to the penalty box for a forearm. So this is a huge opportunity for Slay.
And as I've mentioned probably more than once, Slay is capable of a 24-point jam and will want that right now, because that would make a huge difference to this game as we head into the last 7.5 minutes.
So power jam set up here. Perth in a line on the inside at turn two, getting ready to make some openings for their jammer, and they are popping in front of the pack to hold them, but Helsinki's Kallio does not fall for it. They are able to bring Slay all the way to the outside line. Back on the track is Lionheart with the star. So Kallio is going to focus on playing defense right now for the moment at the front, at the far straightaway. The pack is stretched almost across the far straightaway.
And we see Schrodinger and that's Dawson. Just the loose blockers, just not committing to the formations, just allow them to get up and play some offense. But we see L coming in there for Kallio, trying to disrupt the tripods.
Fans are starting to get vocal here at our European Continental Cup. And that is going to be the end of the jam for Slay.
So don't forget that we are playing for a bronze medal here at the Continental Cup.
So an 8-0 jam in Perth's favor. And I think if you're not making a lot of progress, like Slay was having some difficulty at the end there, if you think you've got your 4 points, you want to get out of it and into the next jam so that you can set yourself up for more opportunities. Kallio 117, Perth 70, 6 minutes and 19 seconds left.
And so not a single team timeout has been taken. Just one team timeout, and that
Magical.
Was right at the end of period one.
What witchcraft?
Oh, look at Babel right in there. We're trying to assist, just trying to put these Kallio blockers off.
So Fable jamming for Perth. Kamasutra, the jammer for Kallio, is able to make it through. Fable removing the helmet cover, looking for some pivot assistance. Is going to find it, I think.
And Kamasutra is in, but there's a recycle, and that's Wood once more. But Wood has picked up a penalty. So just one to beat at the back. Oh, no, there were two. Hiding behind the referee.
Secret blockers, Riggs.
That was nearly a jukebox special there from Molitov, but couldn't quite take Kamasutra out.
So here's BJ again with the helmet cover, looking for some room past this Kallio defense. Meanwhile, Kamasutra able to make it around for 4 more points, and Perth popping forward to try to help BJ at the apex between turns 3 and 4. BJ around the outside on toast tops is beautifully reabsorbed here by Kallio.
Are anybody's shirts going to survive this season with the amount of shirt whips we have seen? You're going to have to order even more jerseys, Darby. What are you doing? Not that you need any more. Oh, we always need more. Why am I kidding?
When do we? Yes, exactly. How often do you wash your scrimmage jerseys?
Well, we have a whole drawer full. I'm surprised they haven't walked themselves to the washing machine at this point.
What's a washing machine? Oh, never mind. Back to the action. Kamasutra still hung up at turn 4. And a nice hit out here from Perth's defense.
Kamasutra smiling all the way back to the bench there. They're having the time of their lives here in this bronze medal matchup
they
at the Continental Cup.
It's a 10-0 jam they just got out of. Kallio 127, Perth 70, 4 minutes and 12 seconds left. We need a moment, Riggs.
I genuinely just thought, oh, my days. So it's Ikarpov on the line, huddled up nice and close to Shock, and the blockers were all piled into the middle, but Shock driving through very physically.
Karpov looking for some room on the middle, and I like the way Karpov is pushing to the middle. But Perth is really eager to stick this formation on the pivot line. I gotta say, the offense for both teams has been really great. Both teams. That was L.
Yeah, just tried to take out the pivot for Perth, resulting in the penalty there.
which has happened quite a bit today in most of the games, but we've got Shock still pushing forward. The pack is at turn two, eyeing up the far straightaway.
Kallio is in block of trouble too in the box right now, and I'm just having a look at our penalty screen. We've got two skaters sitting on five penalties, but we do only have 3 minutes left of the game, so I don't think anybody needs to worry just yet.
Shock coming in for some points. Again, Perth has 70, Kallio 127, under 3 minutes left.
And Kallio with just a two wall out there, still managing to contain Shock. Ikapov is now the highest scorer with 53 points picked up. Shock so far has 22, but has picked up some more points in this jam, of course. So 26 right now.
And a star pass has been enacted to Ella.
Ella just had a little sit down in the box, so good shout.
It's a good rest. Yep. It rests you up for taking that star, I think, Riggs, perfectly.
It does indeed. And WFTDA would like to thank Atom Skates, Antic Skates, Quick Bearings, Powerdyne, Radar Wheels, Rydell, and S1 Helmets for all of their support with all of these tournaments. Thank you very much.
So a 6-0 jam in favor of Perth there, now at 76 points. Kallio, 127. You said no one had taken team timeouts before. We've got plenty of time to use here with just 2 minutes on the game clock.
Slay versus Teabag. And Slay is pushing hard on the inside. Teabag was on the outside, but now sticks to that deep water in the middle. Number 44, Wazer, just trying to push them out, but can't do so. Teabag driving up between turns one and two now.
Teabag continuing to move, pushing the pack towards the far straightaway, one to beat. Now two to beat, beautiful reabsorption here. There's gonna be a lead jammer call and a forearm assess to 6-0, 6-0 Wood.
And now the penalty troubles are all on Perth's side. A jammer is in the box. This is a power jam right now. Slay got themselves in there. That was for a back block, I believe.
So recycled to the infield is Teabag.
Oh, BJ, look at this for hero work right now. Slowing down and a penalty kill all by themselves. The one loneliest blocker.
Lonely but effective, Riggs.
Oh, absolutely.
Coming back into the fray is Slay being drawn back to the far straightaway as Teabag is going to get through. Sorry, there's a penalty assessed to Wazer.
Absolutely, Teabag did not scrub any speed off coming in there and executed that entrance to the pack beautifully.
So Perth trying to slow down Teabag at turn four, able to do so.
And more effective blocking in there from BJ, who just drives Teabag out.
Oh, right around the outside is Slay. There was a scrape of the wheel against the outside track boundary, but no cut. So Teabag takes a look at teammates and says, maybe you can help me out here for some offense. I love the way Kallio plugs this formation. They're able to play offense and defense at the exact same time here between turns three and four as Slay bends around the outside of this formation here. And here we go, Riggs. Control of that jam from Kallio brought us to the final score.
How is it over? I just wanted to carry on.
Oh, was it over?
Forever.
Yes.
I was not ready for that to end. Oh, the unofficial scores right now, 82 to Perth, but Kallio, our fabulous host here at the WFTDA 2019 Continental Cup in Helsinki, Finland, have been ever so wonderful, and they've got themselves a medal.
So exciting for this host. They have done not only a tremendous job on the track, but their work as hosts this weekend was just so lovely. Everything about this tournament has been brilliant. They have fed volunteers. They have comforted us when we have not felt, when we felt we can't go on. No, they just have done a lovely job.
They really have, and they are such good people. Kallio, Rolling Rainbow, always reminding us to be better humans with their safer space policies, their calls to action for the land acknowledgement and the Sami community.
Our inclusion manager, who has done just a fantastic job of trying to manage any concerns that the staff has had on site this weekend. Not only did they want to put on a great and fun tournament, they wanted it to be safe and inclusive, and That is beautiful, and it's what the WFTDA is about.
I have absolutely felt the love this weekend. But you know, I've got some love for Perth. I've never seen Perth before, and this weekend, oh, they've been an absolute joy to watch.
They should be so proud of themselves. They've done a tremendous job, and they played such physical, exciting games to watch. It was always till the end
absolutely.
That they were making it exciting.
And I mean, if I can get myself a fantasy roller derby team going, I tell you, you slay.
Oh.
Slay is getting in there.
I would join your fantasy roller
Excellent.
Derby team, may I?
You may. I am having a word with
okay.
a man. I'm having a word with a man about this.
Okay.
But wow, what a game. We had 21 jams in the first half and 17 in the second. These blockers made it work today.
Yeah, it was really fantastic. And again, Kallio having a much more successful go with their formations against Perth, who they had not played before, than they had earlier in the day against Dock City. And they really shined with their walls and their defensive formations, both teams. The thing that I loved the most about this game, though, was the work from the pivots. The pivots knew where they had to be. And I think sometimes you get overly excited, perhaps overly desperate on your offense. I saw some penalties from the pivots trying to spring their jammers, but not an overwhelming amount.
Yeah.
And what I did see overwhelmingly was smart pivoting. They were where they needed to be most of the time.
Let me back you up on that. KO only picked up 3 penalties in the entire game, and BJ only 1.
Brilliant.
Beautiful pivot work. If you're a pivot, they are pivot goals.
Yes.
Definitely. Listen to the atmosphere in here. I hope you can hear it. This might be my favorite Eurovision song ever. A little bit of Euphoria. Played after Kallio win, and I'm sure that might be their tune, and it is a fabulous one. I'm feeling the euphoria. How about you?
I am feeling the euphoria as well. I think that the final game is going to hype people up enough to last the rest of the week, hopefully, this game and the one coming up, which is going to be for the gold.
I am hyped. I am absolutely hyped for this gold medal game. And it's going to be Antwerp versus
Dock City,
of course. That escaped me for a moment.
I had you.
You had my back. You've had my back this
whole
game. I'm sorry. I'm just so in love with Antwerp at the moment.
They've played
stunning derby all weekend. Totally deserve to be in the final. And I'm not going to lie, I kind of want to see that Cinderella story, the 8th seed coming in, upsetting everybody and taking the gold home.
I kind of wish that was how the Cinderella story actually went. Instead of a slipper on a staircase, it was like a roller derby team smash.
Yeah. If you lose your shoe, you're just drunk, aren't you?
It's a story about a drunk. What's interesting? Well, what's going to be interesting is the final game. We're so excited to bring it to you in just a little bit. There is going to be a short delay for the start of the gold medal game because we did start this game a little bit late.
Yeah. So we need to catch our breath after that.
We're
going
to need to take a break. Right. You might need to take a break, which is probably pretty important.
Rehydrate. Get yourselves ready because gold and silver await.
Well, I'm Double H here with Riggs. Thank you so much for calling this game with me.
Thank you for having me. And we have been joined by the wonderful Valkyrie, who has been doing our lovely stats. So if we sounded smart, it's all thanks to
Val. Not us at all. Anyway, we'll be back in just a bit with the gold medal game. Thanks for watching on WFTDA.tv. Okay.